Welcome, everybody, to the first annual SND NFL Podcast Show. I am Steven, here with Dan.
Good evening, everybody. Thank you for listening.
Welcome to our show. This will be posted on our Facebook pages, our Twitter page. We do have an official SND NFL Podcast Twitter page, at SND NFL Podcast.
See that 10 times fast.
Just did it twice. You're up.
Also, our Facebook page, like us, SND NFL Podcast.
We will be launching that. This will be...
We're going to try to do it weekly.
We're going to do the best we can for you guys. We're going to talk some Jets. We're going to talk some Giants.
We're going to do fantasy. We're going to do some point spreads.
We'll give you our picks for every week for the Giants Jets. And then we're going to do a little fun where we each pick one game or two games.
Yeah, one or two random games that no one's going to really think of and everything like that. But once the season heats up after Thanksgiving, we're going to try to do whatever the best game of the week is and everything like that. The quick little background, our names are Steve and Dan. I'm Dan, he's Steve, like we mentioned before. We're big-time Giant fans, and we just love football, so we figured, why not give this a shot?
We're just going to do this for some fun. What else are we going to do?
Yes, so ask us questions weekly. Hopefully we get some, and we will...
Give you fantasy advice, anything. Any NFL fantasy advice, not just Giants and Jets, of course. We'll do any games that you need. If you're into betting, we will... Or Pick'em League, we will... If you need us to pick a game, we'll do that for you.
All right, that's pretty much our intro. Now we're going to talk about the New York Football Jets.
Everybody really calls them New York Football Jets, because
they're the only Jets. I know, I was trying
They're the J-E-T-S.
Jets. Yes, that's my Chris Brown. Anyway.
No, we're not wearing fireman hats while we say that, so I apologize.
Speak for yourself. Anyway, the Jets beat the Indianapolis Colts this week.
They got lucky. They played a young quarterback. They needed that in their system, though.
Lucky.
It's a confidence booster.
Yeah, they played
luck, so they got lucky.
I see what you did there. Sean Green had a good game. Mark Sanchez had an efficient game. Their defense stepped up, played well, had a couple turnovers. Their special teams, as always.
Joel McKnight, another big kick return early in that game.
The wizard that is Coach Westhoff with another fake punt for Tebow with little Florida old school Florida with jump pass for a big gainer. The Jets just played really well all facets of the game. The Colts are still a very young team that doesn't know how to play on the road, and the Jets took advantage of it.
They've got that young offensive line, so the Jet rookie defensive line needed boost. Copels.
Was Muhammad Wilkerson, who is a second-year guy, but he's still relatively young. And Maven finally showing up. It was very good to see the Jets... D line finally getting to the quarterback and getting a bunch of sacks for the first time in a while instead of Coach Ryan going after with blitz schemes and everything like that with their styles.
Like I said, they needed that. So it was a confidence booster for that team. Need a little help.
With the big cluster that is the AFC East, everybody is 3-3. The New York Jets are playing the best team, the pretty girl of the division, the New England Patriots. Let's face it, they are the.
Before we get into
that,
just a reminder: Sean Green did go 32 for 161, 3 touchdowns, which is huge.
Yeah. Save my fantasy team, maybe my season. who knows? For that, thank you, Sean Green. Finally.
If you're listening, of course.
Definitely not.
Tebow was 1 for 1 with 23 yards, but you know what? That was a confidence booster for that whole team.
Yeah, the Jets played well. On to this week against...
This is a tough week.
This is definitely a tough week.
They're going to the Empire.
They're going to the Gillette Stadium, where it's been a house of horrors other than the playoff game, but notoriously have been a house of horrors for them. And especially with New England coming off a tough loss against the Seattle Seahawks,
I mean that they blew in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they blew the game, may we add. It's just going to be a tough matchup for the Jets. It's inconsistent Jets.
Anytime you play Tom Brady, it's a tough matchup.
And Belichick. It's they're going to be ready to go. With their arsenal in the offense, they're going to be ready to go and try to kick the living you-know-what out of the Jets. Right now, the point spread is 11.5 Patriots for those people.
So we're going to do some picks for this game.
Yeah, before we do the picks, we'll say what we feel about this game. I'll be honest with you. The Patriots are going to be a little too much for the Jets this week. The Jets are still highly inconsistent. They were able to beat the
Bills.
They've beaten the Bills, Dolphins, and then the Colts. They have not faced a quality team yet, and beating a quality team yet. I know I'm going to catch some flack, but facts are facts. I just don't see the Jets faring well, because especially in New England after the Pats losing last week, because it's just going to be rough. The Jets, they're just a ticking time bomb week to week. We don't know who's going to do what and who's going to get X, Y, and Z carries and who's going to get the ball, Tebow or Sanchez. At the end of the day, it's going to... There's my intro roll. We should do ding, ding, ding. Anyway.
We'll add the ding, ding, dings in later.
Yeah. Anyway, back to the Jets. I just don't see them doing anything special this week.
I think the Jets could put up points against this team. I honestly think that they're going to come out with a game. I think one issue the Patriots always had
is the secondary.
It's not just the secondary. Sobrano's defense, offensive schemes against the Patriots have always been good.
Yeah, but they don't have Ronnie Brown as their running back as Wildcat.
Yeah, but that's why Tebow adds that different aspect, because he can throw the ball. Ronnie Brown can't throw the ball. Tebow throws that aspect of throw the ball. So
yeah.
Tebow goes back there. Remember, the Jets played well when they had Brad Smith against the Patriots. Was when the Jets played well against them. Granted, a couple times they had that offensive Randy Moss and Walker going after them, but it is what it is.
This is very good statement, so I can't...
So
you hit it on the head.
I think the Jets are going to fare well this week. But we'll get into that later.
I just think the Patriots are going to cover the 2-touchdown spread. It's going to be one of those days. Sorry, Jet fans, but...
It's a 2-touchdown spread. Is it 2? It's about 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, it's 11.5, right?
11.
Oh, it's just 11. All right, pretty much 2-touchdown spread. I just think the Patriots are just too strong offensively for the Jets, and especially losing Revis and...
Yeah, but New England's defense is based on their pass rush. I think Jets are going to leave a couple guys in as protection. You're going to see Powell a lot on passing plays to sit back and protect Sanchez. They're going to throw a lot of schemes out on Tebow on special teams. A lot of trick plays, but also then again, Bill Belichick will probably send the punt block on every play.
Okay. So what do you think the score is going to be this week?
I'm going to say it's going to be a high scoring game. Weather's going to be nice Sunday all over the place from what I'm hearing. I'm going to say Jets cover.
Okay.
And they're going to put up 31 points. 35-31.
Okay, that's pretty bold. That's actually good. That's pretty cool.
And you're going to see some Tebowing in the end zone.
I'm going to be more conventional and say it's going to be more of the likes of the Patriots 27, Jets 14.
Okay.
I'm being boring and not going on a limb. I just think the Patriots are going to just come in and smack it around.
Also, everybody that is going out and betting, if somebody wants money and is about to break your legs, not get those picks from us. Just a reminder. You did not get those picks from
us. Don't listen to Steve's 31 point jet.
Well, when they put up 31 points and someone wins $1 million, you give me a call.
That's when Steve will be your friend. Anyway.
Yes, you could throw out the juju if you would like.
He already did it. I didn't need to say it. And we're on radio right now. Anyway. Alright.
More importantly to you and me, how about them G-Men?
Alright, let's finally talk about the team that we love, the New York Football Giants. I'll be honest with you, I did not see this week coming. I thought they would pull out a win, but I didn't think it would be as easy as it came.
Listen to us in our predictions.
It was a total team effort, always. Our running game, again, our offensive line carried Ahmad. Ahmad had a great game. But I still don't think Ahmad is fully healthy, and I don't think he'll ever be as healthy as he used to. He doesn't have that burst that he used to.
Well, four ankle surgery, that's what happens.
Yeah,
foot, ankle.
But Bradshaw is definitely not what he used to be. But he had a great game. 2 weeks in a row, over 100 yards. What else can we say about that? That's a very productive game.
27 for 116 and a touchdown.
Yes, very against the San Francisco defense, who barely gives up any touchdowns to running backs at all, is very impressive.
You know we're having a big game when Ahmad runs the ball 20-plus times.
Yeah.
That's when you know our offense is clicking. Everything's going our way. When Eli's got to throw 50 times a game, we know that he can do it, though.
Yeah.
That's the advantage.
I definitely thought it was going to be the typical heart attack game, and Eli decides, look what I can do in the fourth quarter. We're for a field goal and everything like that.
He barely did anything in this game. 15 for 28, 193.
Today we're going to talk about the key, though, was the defense. At the end of the day, Antoine Roll has two picks. I'm sorry, I'm watching NFL Network right now, and we just saw Sidney Rice's bear, but that was... anyway,
never helps you sleep at night.
Anyway, Antoine Roll with two picks, and that was nice to see. Our defensive line finally getting to the quarterback, finally. JPP with two sacks. We just had six total sacks in general. It was very nice to see, refreshing. We just shut them down for 3 points, and Akers missed a couple kicks, which was very rare, so we'll take that as that comes.
He doesn't do that often. Last year, perfect, eh?
Yeah, last year he went perfect, and he's had a good year this year. He hit a 63-yarder, so you know he's been on key.
It's October.
It's October.
Typical Giant October football.
Yeah. Let's talk about this week. This week is a division rival. The Redskins are coming into town.
0-2 last season.
0-2 against them. So I'm hoping the boys will be ready to go and just all systems go this week against RG3. We're going to need our defense to be ready for everything.
We just have to send that line. That's what we got to do.
Yeah, we got to
send that line.
We have to hit RG3 early and often.
OC, stay in your spots.
Yeah, OC has to stay in his spot. Last game against the Eagles, OC got torched every time he went up trying to get Vic. He got sucked in every time. This week, RG3, he can be had. He's a rookie.
Hit him hard.
Hit him hard.
Just like when Vic runs, you hit him hard. He runs like Vic.
Yeah.
He doesn't go outside. He goes straight ahead.
RG3 is an animal. I'm going to give credit where credit's due. But he is a rookie. He can be had. The Giants just have to read their keys and just play solid football and smart football and don't let anybody behind you in the secondary.
They love that deep ball in Washington.
So I think it's the key of this week. It's the D, because our offense is gonna put up our normal offense input. I firmly believe I believe it's going to be a normal Sunday for our offense. So.
I think the defense is starting to click, and the fact that we got Chris Canty back at practice.
Yes.
He probably will not play this week. I'm going to predict him as an out because he's just coming off the PUP list. You got to ease him back into it.
I'm actually the opposite. I think Canty is going to play just for the sure. He's not going to get as many snaps as one would think, but I think he will suit up because he's been out for this is week 7. He's been out for 6 weeks. He's been ready to go. I think he's been ready to go for the last couple weeks, but you can't start playing until week 6. So I think he's going to be ready to go, and it's going to be refreshing to see him play again.
So nice weather, fun tailgate.
Yeah, I'm gonna be at the game. Steve's at every home game, I'm gonna be at the Sherrer home game, which is gonna be exciting.
J8, come by if you're there. If you know us, you probably have our numbers. So hit us up. We'll be there from about 8 o'clock in the morning on. Hanging out, eating some good food, and just having a good time like always.
So all
right, let's go to prediction.
No, we didn't talk about the Giants' offense yet.
Offensive line?
No, just in general. I think the offense. I think it's going to be a Victor Cruz, Akeem Nicks kind of game. You did say earlier to me in just prep. You think Dominic Hickson is going to have
two touchdowns? Call it right now.
He's calling it. Dominic Hickson is going to score two touchdowns. I think their offense is just going to be oh-hum offense. The spread's 6, you said.
6.5.
So 7
six and
points.
A half.
I'm going to take the Giants. They're going to cover, and I'm going to say it's 24. I'm sorry. What did I say before? I said it is. Sorry about that. Written down. It's going to be 24-17. G-men. And I just think the Giants are just a better team. We're just going to outsmart them. We're going to have our moments, typical Giant game. But at the end of the day, ding, another Andrew Roll reference. We're just going to be better than them, and we're going to pull it out at the end. What do you think, Steve?
I'm going to say it's going to be your typical NFC East matchup. Hard nose, smash mouth, in your face football. 21-17. Hickson with two touchdowns. Bradshaw's going to get in the end zone again. And it's just going to be it's going to come down to a big fourth down at the end of the game, under 2 minutes. And we're going to have to come up with a big stop to win the game.
Alright.
Just a typical NFC smash mouth, let's go. Hard hitting game.
Okay, awesome. So you have the Giants winning, but not covering.
Right.
Okay. All right. So
now we're gonna have a little bit of fun.
Here comes the fun part of the evening.
We're gonna each pick out a game. We're gonna do two games each, where we're gonna throw it to our partner, and they will do the prediction for that game. First game I'm gonna throw at Dan is a matchup nobody expected to be big this week. The 4-2 Arizona Cardinals at the 4-2 Minnesota Vikings.
All right. Definitely no one saw this week coming. Definitely both teams overachieving. This would be the time of the year that every predictor and every expert would be, is these guys for real pretender or
contender
type of thing. I'm going to go with the Vikings on this game. I just think Ponder is a more solid quarterback at the moment.
Who's starting this week?
What? We don't know if Skelter or Cobb is going to be
Cobb's
playing. Cobb is out.
Okay, Cobb already been announced out. He's out a couple of weeks with those rib injuries.
That's right. Okay, I apologize.
We don't know if it's Skelter. We never said if he's healthy or not.
Okay, so I'm definitely going with the Vikings. Because they have a quarterback. And a little bit better.
Have you seen the Arizona offensive line?
Yeah, this is true. I think Jared Allen's going to have a big game, and Percy Harvin's going to be Percy, and they have AP. I think the Vikings are more legit than the Arizona Cardinals. I think the Cardinals slipper is going to fall off sooner rather than later. That's how I feel with that game. I think the Vikes are just gonna run by it. Let's see. What is another? Let me see. Who should I have for you pick? All right. Let's see. How about for you? All right. What do you think about the Baltimore-Houston matchup?
Baltimore-Houston's going to be an interesting game. Ravens are hurt. Yeah, Lewis is down. I think he'll still be there at the game. Is it home? It's a home game for the Ravens, right?
No, it's on the road in Houston. So I'm gonna
say that he travels no matter what, because that's the type of player that he is.
I don't think he is, for the sure fact that players who hurt normally don't go on the road.
Yeah, but he's not your normal hurt player.
Yeah, we'll see about that.
He was put today on the list, though. Keep in mind the list. They do have this year the IR list. That means the player can come back. Uh-huh. He was put on that list. They do say he could be back for the postseason. But you know what? Houston coming off a big loss. Thanks again, Aaron Rodgers, for killing me in fantasy football, by the way. I'm going to take the Texans because J.J. Watts is a beast in his own mind.
I think last week Houston, and if every NFL team has that one week of mulligan, I think last week was just one of those weeks for the Houston Texans.
That's why they play the game every Sunday.
They're definitely the team to beat in the AFC this year. They have Arian Foster. Their offense is just ridiculous.
Wait for Andre Johnson to step up again.
Yeah, their defense is stepping up. J.J. Watts is arguably the best player. Could be the defensive player of the year so far, just with everything he's been doing. I think the Texans are just too much for the Baltimore Ravens this week. So I'm also taking the Texans as well.
Okay, next game I'm going to throw at you. Cowboys in Carolina.
Okay. That can that be the one of the most inconsistent games of the season?
Although the Raiders are playing the Jaguars this week.
Well, from the standpoint of teams being overhyped and not showing what they could be this year.
It's not November yet. Wait till November, then roll in place.
This is very true. My heart says I want hope Carolina wins. I think Dallas is going to pull one out.
It's going to be interesting.
It's going to be, honestly.
Which team on each side shows up?
You asked me the hardest game because both teams are so Jekyll and Hyde. We don't know which Cowboy team's going to show up. Is it the Cowboy team that showed up versus the Giants and their other win? Or is it going to be the team like last week just choking a game away? But I could see the Cowboys taking care of Carolina in Carolina. The Cowboys offense is too much for the Panthers defense. It's going to be a shootout, but Dallas wins at the end of the day.
Ding ding.
Ding ding. Another intro. I don't even try to do that, by the way.
He doesn't.
All right. My last matchup for you, Steve, is Bengals or the Steelers. When the Bengals are going... Oh, sorry. Pittsburgh's going into Cincinnati to play the Bengals.
This is an interesting matchup.
May I also add, this is the first time under Tomlin that the Pittsburgh Steelers are under the 500 this late into the season. Sorry, I had to add that little
moment. Thank you. This is an interesting Sunday night football. Since he's a young team, how do they take the pressure of being under the lights? Dalton played in one big game. I remember that. But that was the Rose Bowl 2 years ago. It's interesting. They went 0-2 last year against a team that had James Harrison, and they also had
Troy
Polamalu playing last year. This year, on the other hand, no Harrison.
He's been in and out. I read an article today that he's had over 10 concussions in his 10-year career. That's kind of crazy. Once you
he
hear.
He also has no money because of all the fines, but yeah, that's a different story.
But I don't know. It's gonna be a toss up. It's an NFC North, AFC North battle.
Same thing as an NFC East battle. It's pound and ground. I think that the Bengals are gonna actually pull this one out late. It's gonna be a close game. AJ Green, I'm gonna go out on a limb. I'm gonna say he's gonna have 2 touchdowns this week. He's becoming one of those elite players in the league. He's fun to watch. Bengals are a young team. I think they're going to pull this one out. Steelers are getting old. Offensive line troubles always hurts every team.
I think this game's going to be close, but I think the Steelers need just a bit more than the Bengals, and the Steelers are going to eke it out.
All right, I got one last thing for you before we get out of here.
Okay.
Shoot. Super Bowl prediction.
Super Bowl prediction. Wow. If I had a pick right now.
Right now, based on the first 6 weeks of the season.
Jeez. All right. Super Bowl prediction from the first 6 weeks of this year. Oi. All right.
And we're going to lock them in for the rest of the season.
All right. How about I'll ask you can give me your answer first, because you're the one with the answer. I would assume you have.
I don't have the answer.
Just
came up and
just popped up.
Popped up in my head.
Right.
Let's go at it right now.
All right. For the AFC, it's a lot more jumbled up. I'm gonna go front runner, and I take that back. Let's see. I think my original Super Bowl pick was the Baltimore Ravens, but with Ray Lewis on the IR.
Remember, he might play in the postseason.
Yeah, I don't know. Now they might not even make the playoffs, which I'm sure they will, but there is that chance that they won't. If everything goes to plan in Houston, I think Houston can make a run for it. With their offense and their defense, I think they can make a run. So right now, as of October 17th, I will go with the Houston Texans. And for the NFC, unfortunately, I do want to say the Giants, but I don't think so. You never know. But my heart wants to say Giants, but I think the Packers are going to go back into the Super Bowl this year.
And of course, we have the same matchup. I've said it since the beginning that it was going to be Houston versus the Packers.
Really?
Then I called it week one, Houston Packers. I said to my friend the other day, you're going to watch a Super Bowl preview tonight. I kind of hope for a little bit more of a competitive game.
Yeah.
Hopefully Houston will show up. It is going to be fun seeing it in New Orleans. But, well, that's our show for this week.
By the way, like I said, this is our first week of hopefully many to come. Feel free to join our, follow us on Twitter at S&D NFL Podcast, or like our Facebook page, S&D NFL Podcast. I know that's a lot of wordy.
We also have an email address. You can send us questions every week. Send us comments. We'll answer them. We'll read some of the comments. We'll take tweets. We're here for your pleasure.
Thank you, guys, and have a great night.
Good night, guys.